Hi, this is Mannan Shaah and you're watching me on Soundbox India. Well, I feel the music industry, especially our Indian music industry, it's a growing market, and a lot has been influenced by the social media nowadays, that, you know, Facebook, YouTube and Twitter and all different types of social media platforms have been coming up. So people have been putting up their own stuff, and I have been seeing a wide variety of talent being noticed lately. So it is definitely a far better and a far bigger growing market than what it used to be earlier. Yeah. See, in our country, to be very honest, film is a huge market even today. The singles is a growing, so independent music, like film music, it will become, eventually it will become as good as film music, where artists are going to be getting their due. It has already begun. Well, international market mein agar aap dekho toh, it is only it's only singles, you know. There aren't film based music over there. There are soundtracks, there are background music soundtracks, like, you know, films like Inception, or if you see Interstellar, or Pursuit of Happiness. So they have score composers like Hans Zimmer and Andrea Guerra and all those people. So they get noticed because of their film score compositions, which is also, you know, it's not much, you know, developing in India, but singles like, you know, Taylor Swift, and you have, you know, single composers and artists like Taylor Swift or Adele or, you know, Bryan Adams, or, you know, they've been very popular faces.
Right.
So like that, we are getting that culture in our country now. Eventually, I think it'll, in the next, I think maybe 10 years or down the line, yeah, that this is going to be a very big scene. But right now, today, when you ask me, film music is definitely big right now. It's it's far bigger than independent music. Yeah, no, Commando 2 and Namaste England was just 1 year gap. Commando and Commando 2 was a long gap, because I was exploring, I wanted to, you know, reinvent myself in terms of composing. I wanted to study even more. I was studying a lot, you know, into background music, background film scoring and stuff like that. So I was into my own process, and I thought of taking some time off, you know. I wanted to learn more and more.
Okay.
So yeah, that is the reason why that gap. Now there won't be gaps.
Okay.
So yeah, that's what.
Okay.
I compose. I'm not a lyrics writer, but I compose music. So, the lyrics of Namaste England have been done by Javed Akhtar Saab. Mm-hmm. So, I compose keeping in mind the script.
Okay.
I read the script. I, in fact, read the script of Namaste England for 3-4 times and studied each and every song situation that was given to me in the brief.
Mm-hmm.
So, I studied and I started, you know, working on the mood of the situation.
Okay.
And that's how I cracked a few compositions, and I played it to Vipul ji, and well, he loved a few of them, and then we went ahead with further jamming sessions, and, you know, more and more songs I played, and that's how we cracked the whole album.
Okay.
Yeah, I loved it. We enjoyed a lot. In fact, working with Javed Saab, Vipul ji was itself a very big experience. Vipul ji has a wonderful sense of music. He has a brilliant sense of understanding music, you know, keeping in mind all his previous films that he has worked on and directed, made or produced also. May it be Namaste London, or may it be even Vakt for the matter, and Singhis King as a producer. I mean, they were all amazing albums, and they have had chart-busting music, and, you know, it was a challenge to work with him. And I'm glad that I'm happy that he has liked my work, and we had a good time. We definitely had a good time. Well, I would say Namaste London is my personal favorite album. I love that album very much, you know, all the songs, and they have certain character. And as I said, Namaste England is not similar to Namaste London at all. It's a very different album, and because the story is absolutely different. It has a new cast, and, you know, it has a new story to tell, and there is a different approach required for the music of this particular film. So there is nothing similar about the two albums. Here I concentrated more on rag based music because of the requirement, because this time this whole film was shot, you know, 50% of the film was shot in Punjab, and the rest of the film was in London. And whereas in Namaste London, 70-80% of the film was based in London, and just a few portions were in Punjab. So that is the difference, and you know, the lingo and the dialect of this film is far different from Namaste London.
Okay.
So yeah, it's actually very difficult to compare these two films. One cannot compare. Just the name Namaste is there. Otherwise, everything is very different about both the films. Yeah. Well, with films, it becomes very easy to, you know, because you have a situation, you have everything in mind, you have actors who present your songs. Otherwise, I reach out to audience with live music. I come out and open through social media, and you know, I interact with each and everyone. I believe in interacting with audiences, what they like, what they don't like. It's very important to know what they like. Challenges, yes, I wouldn't say challenges. I had a good journey. I always take it as a journey. Every film for me is a new beginning. For me, every film is a first film. I don't look back in my past and see films that I worked on. They've gone. The next project, absolutely new, because that project requires something which, you know, you don't relate to in your previous projects.
Right.
So that I have to cater as per that particular film. Singers, I would say, see, they are the presenters of the song. They sing the song and they bring out the song in public. So they carry a certain fan following. They carry a certain followers where, you know, like actors, say for example, जैसे कि कोई भी actor आपकी picture में acting कर रहा है, उनका जो lead, for example, lead actors, they are always going to be more popular and known because people will know them because they are seeing them on screen. One doesn't know the director. Initially in 60s, 70s, people used to see the name of the director and used to see the name of the music director sometimes and go to see the film. So music directors and directors are very popular. Nowadays, it's an era where singers are even more popular than music composers or the people, you know, behind the camera. So, but that's how it is, you know, that's the culture that has been everywhere, not just over here, but internationally also, you know, because they are the ones who are featuring inside. Approach. As I said, I read the script. So when I'm seeing a situation, and on that particular situation, jaise ki in Tere Liye, it's a quintessential romantic number, and it carries a certain emotion. Ki she's going to London and he's seeing her off. So wo jo moment hai, it's a very emotional moment, and suddenly a song just pops up in my mind that, you know, I have to create something like. You know, which gives me a certain sense of a melancholy and adds to a certain depth in that particular situation. So I look into the mood of the situation. Well, I'm presently working on Commando 3, and which is supposed to release sometime next year.
Okay.
And the shoot has already commenced, and we are already done with the first 20-25 day schedule in London. And the next schedule over here begins in Mumbai,
okay.
in December sometime. So I'm already midway, and this is my upcoming project, and I'm really excited. My director is very talented, Aditya Dutt. He has directed some good films with, and he secondly again another director who has a brilliant music sense. His understanding of music is superb. He's given some amazing albums like Aashiq Banaya Aapne. Even the music of Table Number 21 was brilliant. So I'm extremely excited to work with him, and he's a director who understands music really well.
Okay,
yeah, so I'm kind of lucky to have musical directors to be working with.